everyone. I'm Henry, and my Chinese name is Wu Jingyang. And here is my student number, and my subject is automotive design. This is my topic of my presentation. It's very similar as my essay, it's the development of automotive industry's efficiency in developing countries. But my presentation will only focus on China. And this presentation will cost 8 minutes. Then, my presentation have three parts. The first one is the industry introduction and how efficiency it is. And then, I have three reasons of the why it's inefficient. Then, lastly, I will give my conclusion. Let's move on to the first part, the introduction. In China, after 15 years ago, if you are President Mao, your Chairman Mao, you can use this. Red flag, it's a good car in that age. But if you're not him, you only can use this. And if you are lucky, you are a worker, successful worker or officer, you can buy this. No one can image they can have a permanent car by themselves because it's impossible. But things change. In nowadays, in 1977, Chinese have 1 million real vehicles. But in the after 10 years ago, China have almost 51 million cars. And in nowadays, Chinese own 81 million cars. It's an incredible increase. And my essay gives three reasons of that. The first reason is policies. The most important policies is investment from government. Chinese government has invested 1 billion yuan in 1959 because they want to establish some factories for product the vehicles. Then this factory producted 100 trucks for the National Transport Department and some cars for leaders, only for leaders. But after that, in 1918, Chinese government spent 5 billion yuan in this industry. And because of that, many factories established in many cities in China. Another policy is tax. And Chinese government want to protect their local industry, so they use the they up the import tax to protect their local industry. Because in the same price, the cars import from the developed country is better than local cars. So that's a method of the government's use. The second reason is cooperation. Many Chinese companies cooperate with the famous companies in the world, like Guangzhou Honda. This company cooperation with the Honda in Japan, and Shanghai Volkswagen is cooperation too, and Beijing Mercedes. Like this factory, Beijing Industry Factory, he cooperated. This factory cooperated with the Mercedes in Germany and it's locally in Beijing. But the car they produce very cheap, much cheaper than the import car. Like the Beijing Mercedes, the SUV just cost nearby 400,000 yuan. But the imported car from Germany is almost nearby double than that, nearby 800,000. Another reason is the talent. Like this car, it's Harvard H6. This car's designers, not Chinese designers anymore. Its designer come from BMW and Mercedes. It's this company introducing the talents from the famous companies, and it makes this car very successful. And another reason is the international student. Our industry process need many human resources. So Chinese international students go abroad, learning abroad, and take the advanced technology and technology back to China and contribute to this industry. Then I will give my conclusion. China used 10 years from this to this. It's no double that is very efficient. And as for my essay, we have three reasons. It's policy, cooperation, and talent. And here is the reference I used in my essay. And it's the end of my presentation. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.